guys, how's all done today? So today's video is going to be me talking about the end of my last video and the explanation that I done.
But I am so sorry that I haven't uploaded for about 4 days, but I've been back in hospital again. That's also why I haven't done a visual video for about a week now, because I've been feeling and looking terrible.
The reason I was back in hospital is because for over 2 weeks now, I have had quite a bad urine infection, blood in my urine, and recently, like the past 3 or 4 days, I have been getting heart palpitations. Now, I've never had heart problems or something like that before, but this time, it's different. It's so strong. The feeling in my heart, it feels like somebody's just stabbing it, putting it back out, waiting a minute or two, and doing it again. And it's been like this for like 3 or 4 days now. It's getting really hard and it tires me out a lot. I am on quite strong painkillers. I am on a brand new antibiotic that I've never heard of it before. I cannot remember the name right now, but I'll add it into this video. I am also going to be talking just a little bit about my Ehlers-Danlos syndrome and my dystonia. The reason I am doing this is because my new recent subscribers don't really know about my illness. Now, most people don't understand or realise that I actually started my YouTube channel because of my Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Now, I had a previous YouTube channel with quite a few subscribers and it got shut down. Because myself, being stupid, it was my first YouTube channel, didn't really know all the rules and regulations, community guidelines, but I posted something that I did not request. The person didn't actually know that I was recording and didn't know that I put it up. I did not ask for permission, so that's why it got shut down. But it wasn't really a hard choice for me to start up a new YouTube channel because I worked so hard on my last one. I enjoy it so much. It's a passion. Like, for me, I'm not in it for the money or anything like that you can get off YouTube. I am there for a voice for people with or without Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Carers, doesn't matter what kind of illness you have or caring for, please, please, please understand that you are not alone. No one in these kind of situations are alone. There are always other people like myself out there that would love to talk to you. Now, when I was in hospital last week, I did have an appointment with my shoulder surgeon to get an x-ray and just for him to see how it was. But because I was in hospital, I could not get down to the appointment. So I am going to need to make another appointment. I was going to be talking to my surgeon about one female that I've been talking to, but obviously I didn't get a chance to, so hopefully the next time I see him, I should be able to bring up that person's name, and hopefully he might take over her care and start helping her as well. It means so much to me to hear all the positive feedback that I get from everyone, whether it's on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, doesn't matter where it is, the feedback means a lot to me. Like, I'm just a normal small woman from Dundee, Scotland. Most people don't even know where it is or heard of it, but I'm at 95 subscribers. I'm trying my hardest to get to 100. It's only 5 subscribers away, guys. Please, please, please share this video with all your friends, all your families. Also, I'm giving every single person out there the opportunity and the agreement from myself that you could edit out this video and make it into a video of your own. And you could put some memes around it, you could do what you want really. Obviously don't make a nasty video, because I probably will report that. That's not what my channel is for. My channel, I want to keep it upbeat, keep it happy and positive, and keep moving forward. And if you share it, help other people, to help me to help other people, sorry, is just immense. I'm so happy. I'm so close to 100 subscribers. Please help me out and let's try and get to the 100 before the end of this month. So I will be looking down quite a lot in this video, because I have a big huge piece of paper written with a lot of things on it, because I'm not very good at sitting down and thinking stuff up in my head. So for me, it's better to have something written down so I could have a quick look and try and give you the most detail as I possibly could think about into one video. So Wednesday the 19th at about 4 p.m. I went to my local GP surgery because I've been having chest pains for about 3 days now, and a urine infection and blood in my urine for over 2 weeks now. I wasn't even going to phone my GP yesterday, but my partner said that I had to because of the way that I looked. I was not acting myself. I was so drained. Every time I stood up, my head would get so dizzy, and half of the time I would need to sit down on the floor for about 10 minutes just to get the blood to flow back throughout my body. And when I was on the phone to the nurse, when you first phone your GP, you get put through to a nurse if it's an emergency, and then the nurse would relay it to the GP, and then they would tell you to come down or not. So the nurse basically says, come down urgently as soon as you can and we will get you seen. Now the only problem with that is you could be sitting for 1, 2, 3, 4 hours until one doctor has free time to see me, because I was just an emergency. So my GP said it sounds like I have a urine, kidney infection and blood in my urine. That really drains the blood flow throughout your whole body, and that is what has made me feel so faint. She said I had to go straight up to the hospital to at least stay there for 24 to 48 hours. And while in hospital, I would need to get a cannula, which is quite a big needle that they put fluids and drips and medication through. That is a medium-sized needle that goes straight through into my vein. They put that into my vein so I could receive the antibiotics and the fluids. This is a pump that helps pump the antibiotics from the bag through the tubes and then into the needle and then into my vein. As they did not work orally. Now, I have been on oral antibiotics for over 2 weeks, pretty much since the very beginning. I went to my GP and they says it's the quickest I've ever seen. When you dip, it's hard to explain, when you dip this thing into somebody's urine, it'll come up indicators to say what kind of infection it is and if there's blood in your urine and stuff like that. And my GP said it's the first time she'd ever seen it indicating so fast that there was an infection. I actually took two different kinds of oral antibiotics over the past 2 weeks, and they obviously did not work. So when I went to my GP, she says you need to at least spend a couple nights in the hospital to get IV antibiotics, which is intravenous, which is a needle through the vein, and to give me all the medicine. and to give me the antibiotics and the saline, which is fluid, to rehydrate me and basically help my kidneys to try and flush them up. So I pretty much went straight up to my hospital and I got took into, it's like a side room but it has 4 beds, which is a lot better than the 6 to 8 beds that you get in the wards. But I went in there, I got my name band, they pretty much instantly got a cannula into my arm, straight away started giving us fluids. I also got lots of blood taken, I got a nebulizer to help with my breathing. The nebulizer has like a blue inhaler in it and you squeeze and you just keep it breathing and it helps open your airways and helps get rid of the mucus and helps it bring it up so you could just cough it out. And it makes you to breathe, obviously, a lot better. I got up to the hospital yesterday. Obviously, you must have knew that because I made a video yesterday. Also, I'm sorry, it wasn't a visual video, but I've been feeling really bad, really terrible, and just really not up to making it. So, trying to get myself already dressed, a little bit of makeup, hair done, it was just getting impossible. So, that's why over the past week or so, I have been doing just narrations, me narrating videos, so you don't really need to see the way I look. It can be quite embarrassing sometimes when you look not well. Some people could think that, I don't know, like I feel really paranoid sometimes that people think bad things about me and stuff because my weight is not the best and it's just, I don't know, like I feel sometimes people don't think about YouTubers and I don't think realise that we have real lives and real problems and there's some days where we can't upload. And some of the nasty comments that you get saying, oh, you said you would give me a shout out tomorrow and you've not even uploaded a video in 4 days and I'm sitting in a hospital. It's just, some people in the comments could be so evil and I'm trying my hardest, like from the bottom of my heart, I am trying my hardest and I feel I'm not really getting very far. Like there's channels out there and they've only got like 5-10 videos and they've got maybe 3-4-5-6-7 plus 100 views, sorry, subscribers, and I've got over 55, nearly 60 videos and I've not even got 100 subscribers. It's just hard and sometimes I feel like I want to give up. But I can't because I enjoy it so much and it's not like I'm doing these videos for the money or anything like that. I'm doing it to try and get my channel, my story and to help people, to basically give people a voice, and I just need everyone's help to just share these videos as much as you can. Help me out, like, obviously, give my channel a like, obviously subscribe, turn on your notification bells. If you want a shout out, comment below saying post notifications on and you as well get a shout out. Sorry, I got kind of lost off track here, so I'm going to finish my little slash big letter.
2 hours later.
Oh yeah, I also got an ECG, which is like wee stickers. It goes on your heart, around your body. It goes on your wrist and 2 on your ankles. And it takes a trace of your heart to see if there's any murmurs or missed heartbeats or stuff like that. it all came back positive. The only worry with me is my heart rate was going over 140, which is really fast, and this says it's okay though because it was beating regularly, like every beat was at pretty much the same time, and pardon me, and I really wasn't worried too much about my heart, which I am so happy for.
Two hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time, Carl.
Also, I would like to say a huge thank yous all for all your support, and I hope you're enjoying my channel and the content that I'm putting out. I am putting up a mixture of lots of different content, from challenge videos to reaction videos to videos about like Lance Stewart, conspiracy theories, every kind of videos that you could sort of think about, I'm trying to cover and mix them all up to, like, nobody really wants to sit there and watch the same content day in, day out. So, for me, I think it's sort of best, because I can't get out, so I think it's best that I mix up the content, so it's not just me sitting talking or doing the same thing every single video. Comment down below if you prefer it that way, or if you would prefer, like, if I stuck to like something like sports injuries or just injuries or conspiracy theories, or keep it as a mixture. Comment down below and let me know what you think, guys, because everything you say I take in and I try and improve on them things. Halfway through, guys. I'm sorry for making this video quite long. So I'm going to just look at my piece of paper and just read it as easy and as fast, and I'm going to try and slow it down just because a lot of people can't understand what I say because I'm Scottish, and this is the way we all talk pretty much. Just because I'm used to it doesn't mean yous are, so I'm just trying to change my accent and the way I talk to you guys to make it simpler. Anyway, also my shoulder is doing good from the infection, but my hips, ankles and fingers, and that still dislocate almost every day, but it is manageable. EDS is a connective tissue disorder, and it is really difficult and really lonely illness to live with. But when I get down or upset, I just always think there are some people a lot worse off than me. So just smile, be happy, and keep fighting. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for today's video. I hope you all understand about me not uploading yesterday. Please like, share, comment down below, let me know what you think I should do for future videos. Also, I'm so close to 100 subscribers, that is my target for the end of the month, so please hit the big red subscribe button and the little alarm bell just at the side of it, and you will be notified of any videos I post in the future. It means so much to me and makes me so happy when I see all your kind comments and they see my channel grow. If you want a shout out, all you have to do is comment down below saying your post notifications are switched on, you've liked my video and you've subscribed to my channel. I just want to add one final thing before I finish this video. I would like to say a huge shout out to Impossible. I will put a little link in the description below. Please head over to his channel and give him a subscribe. He has helped me so much over these past 3 months. He is going to give me one more shout out, which would be my second one. It means so much to me. I did get 2 or 3 subscribers off his last shout out. Hopefully I could get 5 subscribers with this shout out, and I could reach 100 subscribers. I'm so excited for it, guys, and I've got big plans for my 100 subscriber video. Please hit the big red subscribe button, like, share, comment down below, let me know what to do for future videos. Thanks so much for watching, especially all the way to the end. If you have made it this far, comment down below and say hashtag end. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.
You say you love me, but I don't think that is true.
Yes, that sounds like an excellent thing.